Okay, so this is very one of the very important chapter. The cholinergic neuron is very important chapters as per GPAD is concerned. Okay, and also in your pharmacy, there are a lot of doubt on ANAs. Okay, so let us understand. So I have described the CNS in my earlier video. Okay, and where the brainstem ends. Okay, medulla oblongata brainstem end. From there, the spinal cord starts. Okay, these are the region of spinal cord that I mentioned: cervical, thoracic, lumbar, and sacral. Okay, so these are the region, and the CNS also contain the cranial nerves. Okay, so I have shown a top view. Okay, these are the hemisphere. Okay, over here you have an olfactory nerve, first one. Under that you have an optic nerve. Then oculomotor nerve, trigeminal nerve, okay, facial nerve, glossopharyngeal nerve, and very important nerve, vagus nerves. Okay, and these all nerves are enclosed in the meninges, which is nothing but the combination of arcanoid, dura mater, and the pia mater. In between the nerves and CSF, cerebrospinal fluids, which serve as a protector of the CNS floor. Okay. So this is a very important understanding. Now if you see the cholinergic, the cell bodies, okay, cell bodies of parasympathetic nervous system, okay, it is another name of cholinergic neurons. Parasympathetic nervous system arises from CNS. So this is the parasympathetic nervous system is coming from CNS and innervating the organs, okay. And also there are nerves which is arising from three spinal nerves arising from the sacrum. If you see the three spinal nerves, that is S2, S3 and S4. Okay, so these sacral spinal nerves are coming and also innervating the organs. And in this they are releasing the neurotransmitter acetylcholine. You remember this, because the neurotransmitter for cholinergic is acetylcholine. Okay, mimetic acetylcholine is also known as parasympathomimetic substance. Okay, it is an agonist. So it is very important, and the cell bodies of parasympathetic nervous system, which is coming from the CNS, that include the three vital cranial nerve. Number one, oculomotor nerve. Okay, which is known as third cranial nerve. Then facial nerve, number two, facial nerve, okay, and of course it's known as seven cranial nerve. Then you have glossopharyngeal nerve, and the fourth one. So it is four, okay, not three, four cranial nerve. That is fourth one is vagus nerve, okay. Vagus nerve. So these four nerves, okay, these cranial nerves is a part of your parasympathetic nervous systems. Okay, normally vagus nerve innervate in the heart, lungs, and the digestive system. Okay, they innervate heart, lungs, and the GIT. Very important one, and that's why vagus nerve is one of the longest. Okay, nerve in parasympathetic or PNS, peripheral nervous systems. Okay, now coming to the this branch. So when the CNS nerves or cholinergic reaches to the target tissue, they are always reaching tissues via trigeminal branches. Okay, which is ophthalmic, maxillary, and mandibular nerves. Okay, in trigeminal branch. Okay, they are in a combination of ophthalmic, maxillary, and mandibular nerve. That's why you can say mastication also is a work of your cholinergic nervous systems. Okay, now very important, the end part of vagus nerve is known as nucleus ambiguous, AMBIGWS. Sometimes they ask, but sometimes they do not ask this kind of nucleus. But of course the function. So let us discuss the function of cholinergics. Okay, so one by one the functions is very important. Now the first function, I'll be going with the receptors. When it is interacting with M1 receptor peripherally, and one thing you remember, the neuron which is coming to the peripheral, okay, it is innervating the effector organ. This is known as effector organ, okay. So that means this is known as efferent neuron. And the neuron which is going from the organ to the CNS, okay, known as afferent neuron, okay, A. So E for effector. So that's a very important one. So M1, it is present in salivary gland, okay, which is controlling salivation, okay, salivation. So then coming to the M2, which is present in the heart, like vagus nerve stimulate the M2 by releasing acetylcholine, and it causes decreasing of heart rate, okay, and that is bradycardia if it is excess amount. Then M3, it is in pupillary, you can say pupil ciliary muscle. So in that case it contract. So if pupil and ciliary muscle is contract, then it is increase the flow of aqueous humor takes place, okay. So that's why you have pilocarpine can used to treat glaucoma. Pilocarpine is acting on M3 as agonist, act as acetylcholine, and increase the drainage of aqueous humor, because in glaucoma there is a deposition of aqueous humor takes place, okay. Now after that, if you coming to the peripheral organs, like of course in GIT they all have M muscarinic receptor, that is in GIT, but in skeletal muscle you have a nicotinic receptor, and in ganglia you have a nicotinic receptor. In ganglia we call as NN, okay, and if it is skeletal muscle, so this NM, okay. So in NM it contract the skeletal muscle, so skeletal muscle contraction, motor activity is responsible. And you remember one thing, there is the spinal nerve which is coming from pelvic region, that is the sacral region, we call them, it is pelvic, spelling is splanchnic nerve, okay. This nerve is highly responsible, this innervate, if you see the thoracic and the lumbar, these two part of spinal cord is responsible for transmitting noradrenaline, that is your adrenergic nervous system. I will come after this video to you, okay. So this spinothalamic nerve not only innervate the organs and release acetylcholine, this also can innervate the adrenergic ganglion and release the noradrenaline from the paravertebral ganglion, or you can say sympathetic ganglion, okay, they release the, so that means the action of NN is which present over here, the NN, the inner ganglion, is highly responsible to regulate the flow of noradrenaline from the sympathetic ganglion, okay. Then after that you have M1 receptor.